Hello, I'm Mr. Anitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And Christianity and Sikhism is as simple as ABC, if you go logically. And if you have the understanding, the gist of the subject. So if you don't have the gist of the subject, then you are wondering what is right and what is wrong. So try to get the basics, why Christ Jesus came into this world. Because the rabbis became corrupt. Rabbis are school teachers. And many prophets were sent to tell them to mend their way. As you have inspectors of schools, you know, who go to visit schools to tell the teachers what they are doing right or wrong. So are the prophets who come. And when they come, they tell them right or wrong. Some are very abusive and they beat them. As Jesus told them, you know, when he was coming, that many prophets were sent to you and you maltreated them. And last prophet was John the Baptist. And when he came, they won't allow him inside the temple. So that when shows you the maltreatment they had rendered to the prophets. Then our Father God sent his own Son to sort them up. And that's why Christ Jesus came, to sort them up. And in Son has no power to take the life of somebody. He is to give life. And in India, he came the one to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sword power. And he was the last person, our Father himself, who came and sorted them up. There's a more deeper discussion, but that only when you develop the interest. So there's only one God we have, you know, we don't have two gods, which is supernatural Father. And same, we have one natural Father, Brahma, called Yahweh or Khuda. So one is a potter, this is the pot, and one is the one who puts the soul in, where from the soul come emanates. Soul is of supernatural Father. This is natural. Acts 7:30-38. Moses put on Christ and wrote Torah. So did Jesus bring the holy fire to bake our face. Now, when 40 years, that's 40 years are made of 10 commandments or basic laws times 4, the 4 spiritual states, ego, we call it home in Punjabi, mind, we call it man, or in Arabic called nafs, and in wisdom is a, we call buddhi, in Arabic called akal, and his will, we call it CHITT BIRTTI, or when you are, whatever you willeth, it happens, as Christ Jesus demonstrated, had passed. An angel appeared to him in the wilderness of Mount Sinai, in the flame of a burning bush. Burning bush was the kiln of his word, the Oral Torah, that puts Christ in your heart. Because he was solitary of righteousness and not a blind man that followed others. Remember the other, you know, they told him, who made you a judge and all that, you know. And he was not one who will follow anyone. He was solitary. So only the solitary can have the Holy Spirit in them. Remember, there are, Jesus mentioned, there are two gates, two folds. One fold has a wide gate and wide road. That is the Pharisees, Sadducees, and all those people, you know, which are putting their own views. that is man-made reflections of His word. That's how they interpret it. And then there's one which is the narrow, which has a narrow gate for the solitary. That means one person at a time can go, not two. So you don't follow anyone. Unless you are solitary, you can't find that gate. So Moses was solitary and he found that gate. And that the representation of the burning bush, with not burning itself, but just flame, that it is the from the supernatural power, God, that is the putting Christ into the heart of Moses. So that narrow gate which Jesus has told us that leading to the vineyard of our Father, where the true vine Christ Jesus is planted, for us to go there to suck His blood, or to eat His flesh, which is hear what He said with our ears, and then we drink the blood of Christ when we come out and when we preach gospel to the other people in honor of Christ Jesus, then we are drinking the blood of Christ. So unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in Christ Jesus. This is what He said when He feed the 5,000 people with very delicious food, because manna was fed to the people in wilderness when Moses brought them out as a punishment for repentance, for being unfaithful to Abraham. This story was told by Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son. The elder one is Ishmael, younger one is Isaac, and the father is Abraham. Because they became unfaithful to Abraham, they left the promised land. Remember when Jacob had 12 sons, 11 were crook, only one was good, Joseph. And as soon as they sold Joseph as a slave to the Egyptian, the promised land became barren totally, because there were no person left who is faithful to Abraham. So Yahweh also, who brought Abraham into that promised land, also was angry. So He did not bring any rain to them. So they were made to go hungry. So everything that happened in this world is happened according to our Father's will. If you are faithful to Yahweh, then He will feed you food. And if you are faithful to our supernatural Father, then He will feed you His word through this ear and through revelations. That is what Christ Jesus said, "I have brought the holy fire to bake your faith in God, as Moses' faith was baked in the holy fire." Bush, burning bush. That is at the narrow gate for the solitary seekers of His word that leads to the vineyard of our Father, where the true vine Christ Jesus has been planted by our Father for us to graft ourselves, to eat the flesh of Jesus and come out to the world to preach gospel from our own hearts with great confidence, our authority as our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus was preaching and explaining everything in details. Remember John 4, Samaritan woman at the well stressed that when Christ comes, He will explain to us everything in details, leaving no stone unturned. This woman knew, first she called that Jesus, that you look like a prophet. And then she stressed that when the Christ come, He will tell us everything. That she knew the difference between prophets and Christ. Prophets are whip for the rabbis. Christ tells you the very basics of the Oral Torah, or the His Word. He is greater than the prophets. He is the very Son of God. He was begotten from our Father. This is called Moses put on Christ and wrote Torah. When Moses saw it, he was amazed at the sight. And as he approached to look, there came the voice of our Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Not the Lord Yahweh of creation. Lord Yahweh of creation has nothing to do with fire. He is a potter. He pots, he makes the pot. The one inside the soul comes from our supernatural Father, and that is where the Son of the supernatural Father is called Christ. And that is where the fire comes. He brings the holy fire to bake our faith. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't bake your own faith. So I am the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. Remember that Abraham was a righteous person, like the order of Melchizedek. But Melchizedek was not married. He was not a family man, whereas Abraham was a family man. So Melchizedek was a sadhu, and Abraham was not a sadhu, he was a family man. Sadhus don't marry, they remain solitary, you know. Whether they are male or female, they don't marry. Moses began to tremble and did not dare to look. Elohim, our supernatural Father, is greater than Lord Yahweh, the creator of nature at large, Then the Lord, now this messianic Jews, you know, they have corrupted the Old Testament and the New. When they took over the Church of God and came with the Torah in their hand to poison the Church, so they started to teach them the Torah in the Church. And the Apostle used to come, and then they had no desire to know the New Testament or the Gospel. As you go to the universities where they are teaching the letters of the Old and the New Testament, and you go there and tell them, explain to them the parables, what it means, they have no interest in it. They say it's not written there. And Gospel is by grace, not everybody can get it. But letters, everybody can read it. So they are happy teaching the letters and not wanting to know Gospel. The same situation happened when the Apostle used to go to the Church, and the Church congregation, being fed up with this old Torah, the old wine, written scripture, they desireth not the new wine. So they were not interested in the Gospel. And the Apostle rebuked the bishop, you know, what the hell you are doing? You have brought in the Jewish leaven, which is the written, rotten Torah. And the bishop told them, oh, look, do whatever I tell you to do, or otherwise don't come to my church. Then they opened monastery. And when they opened monastery, the bishop, you know, soon go out blind, gathering again, as they used to have in the temple. And when there were enough gathering, then they influenced the Romans again. They colluded with them as they colluded when Christ Jesus was crucified, when they had the trial and Pilate was in free, wanted to set him free, but the temple priest insisted that he should be handed over to them, he should be killed. So he gave in to them and washed his hand in the sun, that I have nothing to do with this, blood of this man who is innocent. But still, he gave the man to temple priest to kill him. So this Lord word is introduced by the Messianic Jews. We don't have Lord in the royal kingdom of God. Our God is our Father. Father has sons. Lords, they have slaves. As the rabbis have the slave disciples. They do what their teacher tells them to do. Saul had conscience, but his teacher, Gamaliel, told him to do persecute them and all that, you know. And that's what he was doing, to obeying his teacher. So much more I can tell about all these things. Let's carry on with it. Then the Lord once born disciples of the rabbis, know only Lord Yahweh, said to him, take off the sandals from your feet, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. Now this is, you know, looks corruption to me, because sandals and dress has nothing to do with our God, which is supernatural. Supernatural is living in this temple. So you have to be careful of these formality. You know that in church I can't go with my headgear, turban. One church I went there, they say, oh, take it off your turban. But they knew it, you know, that it's I was in a company of some people, so they didn't bother. But they were very keen to see that they do what is written in the Bible. I have surely seen the mistreatment of my people who are in Egypt, and have heard their groaning, and I have come down to rescue them. Come now, I will send you to Egypt with Christ in your heart. It was this Moses whom they rejected when they said, who made you a ruler and a judge? And whom God now sent as both ruler and liberator. Rulers, they are prophets, you know. Prophets are rulers. The sons of the Most High God, they are servant. They are not rulers. So Moses, you know, made them faithful to Abraham and brought them back to the promised land. Through the angels who appeared to him in the bush, he led them out, having performed wonders and signs in Egypt at the Red Sea and in the wilderness for 40 years, where dry manna was fed as sustainer of life. This is the Moses who said to the Israelites, God will raise up a son of Most High Elohim, the Christ, who is greater than the prophet Elijah, John the Baptist, for you from your own people, as he raised me up. He is the one who was in the congregation in the wilderness with the angel who spoke to him at Mount Sinai, and with our ancestors, and he received living oracles to give to us. Only Christ teaches oracles, because it comes from your heart. The gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper. So unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel or oracles. Whilst the prophets teach scriptures, the letters of the law. So scriptures are written. That's why, you know, Jesus forbade, don't take two shoes, or money in your pocket, or script. Script means scripture, written book, like this New and Old Testament, Bible. You don't have to take it with you when you are on preaching spree, because gospel comes from your heart and not from the written book. You can quote it from there, or people can quote you. You can explain to them this is what it means. But scripture, they are old wine. If you get drunk with the old wine, then you won't be able to get the new wine. You go there, sometime I go to the church and ask them something, you know, the man starts reading from one part, then cross-reference, go to another part, cross-reference, go to another part. 5 or 6 times he goes, he's happy. In his heart, he's thinking that he has satisfied me, but not me. When I asked him question, he has no answer. He only can quote the book and not his heart. Gospel rest in your heart. When it's there, then you can explain everything from the basic going up logically. No logic, no gospel. That is why gospel is called logos. Logos mean end product of logical reasoning. So our Father God blesses you.